is off. How are you guys doing? I hope you're doing well. And yes, we are back with Niall Horan and his second album, Heartbreak Weather. I've gotten a lot of comments are like, she forgot about Heartbreak Weather. I'm like, no, I didn't. I just have a lot of stuff to do, but I'm here now. I hope it's okay. I just watched the One Direction This Is Us documentary over on Patreon, and it solidified me as a Niall girl. Niall is so charismatic on stage, I can't. And then he does that! I've never realized like how goofy and just like fun Niall was. Like, he's just insane. And I love that about him. I don't know that he's still that way because this was obviously like 10 years ago, but oh my god, Niall 10 years ago was so adorable and I completely fell in love with him. I feel like more connected to him after watching that movie, and I'm just very excited to get into his second album today. As always, you guys, I will have the uncut version of this album reaction over on my Patreon. On Patreon, you can also get other benefits like these shout outs right here. I'm sending you guys postcards. There's exclusive content such as the This Is Us One Direction documentary film reaction. Thank you so much to everybody who has gone over there already. You guys mean the world to me. You are the reason that this channel exists. So thank you guys so very much. And let's get in to Heartbreak Weather. So here we have the track list for Heartbreak Weather. We have a lot of music videos today. First and foremost, there's just a lot of music videos here. We have 5 music videos. Copyright gods, please be on my side today. The only song that I do know on the album actually is Black and White. Now this song, it's not a song that like I went out of my way to listen to or whatever. It just, I listen to a lot of Spotify curated playlists, and this song is on like a bunch of them, and it always keeps coming on. Every time it comes on, I like try to block it out, but it's so good that I like keep listening, but I'm like, oh, I should save this for the reaction, but I didn't, I'm sorry. And the songs I'm most excited for are Everywhere and Still. I don't know. We're starting today with the title track of this album, Heartbreak Weather, and we have a music video. The thumbnail made it look like this was gonna be like colorful and kind of like abstract and fun. Oh, Niall, we're here finally. It's about time. Oh, oh my god, is he a weatherman? He's a- yes, okay. This is what I'm talking about. That's the energy that he had in the This Is Us documentary. I have not even had time to pay attention to the music because he's been dancing around doing that, and I love it. That is the Niall that was in the This Is Us documentary and that I fell in love with, and that is the reason that I'm a Niall girl. I swear there was lightning. I'm not doing well. I was just sitting here saying, I don't know if he still has that goofy personality. And he clearly does. Ah! Oh my god, I have not been listening to the song. I'm so sorry. Driving around in the dark, finding breezes. Oh my god. I love him so much. No. 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 I don't know what to do. I don't know what to do. Stop. Wait, yo, with me. Niall. Niall. Oh my god, he's literally the cutest ever. No. No. Is he for real? I'm in love with him. Oh my god, his energy is everything to me. I adore him so much. Ah! I don't know what to do. I need to look at the lyrics, hold on, because I liked the lyrics, but I was so distracted by the boy named Niall. The way he was dancing, I was like, that's me. That is how I dance, and like, unironically. It's been heartbreak weather, thinking to myself, it won't get better. But it feels different when you're with me. I'm gonna have a breakdown on the first track. Oh, Black and White is next. So at least I like kinda know this song already. Oh yeah, every time this song would start, I would think it was a BTS song. And I can't think of which BTS song, but the beginning sounds like a BTS song. If anyone is also ARMY here, what song does that sound like right at the beginning? Let me know. Ask me if I wanna come inside, cause we didn't wanna end the night. Then you took my hand and I followed. Wait, the lyrics are so sweet. Okay. 65 in US. When did I first know I always knew? That I love you for the rest of my life. See you sending me your dress. I love you so much. Swearing for me to close my eyes. To see us in black and white. Crystal clear on a starlit night. I promise that I love you. Why is this the sweetest song ever? Oh my god! You're so... He's so precious. Never be another. I promise that I'll love you for the rest of my life. This bitch. Okay, like I said, I've heard that song on the playlist I've been listening to. It's like a good mood playlist or like a morning motivation one. I forget which one it is. But that song always comes on and I never like paid attention to the lyrics until now. And they're so sweet. He's so perfect. He's literally perfect. What am I supposed to do? Why did this person say, imagine Niall singing this in Liam's wedding? I'm crying. Please tell me that didn't actually happen. Wait, I love him so much. I'm having a breakdown. He's so freaking cute. He's so sweet. And just, oh. Next is Dear Patience. Dear Patience, can we share a drink and let go of the pressure? Feels like you don't even know me. Just me and the stars can get lonely. Hey, can you show your face? Can you see that I'm anxious? Can you hear what I'm saying? Dear patience, if I pour my heart, I'll go down blazing. Can you hear what I'm saying? Why do I feel speechless right? I can't talk. Can we share a drink and let go of the pressure? I love that line. I don't know why. I love that line. I love it so much. That song left me absolutely speechless for the first half. I just like lost all ability to speak. Apparently I still can't speak. Cause I fall too fast and I go down blazing. Literally same, Niall, like I feel you there. Dear Patience is basically at the start of the relationship. I was basically writing a letter to the feeling of patience and being like, don't fuck it up. That's why it comes straight after Black and White, because it's kind of contradicting itself. So true. It's like, don't mess this one up. Don't rush in too hard. Wait, I love that track placement because Black and White is like, I'm gonna love you for the rest of my life. And then Patience, Dear Patience is like, hold up, buddy. Think it through first. That I miss you, babe. Wonder what you're doing now. This is a song that I don't need right now. But you're leaving out the truth. And I'm not saying that you're guilty. Cause I don't have any proof. But it hurts so bad. What? Bend the Rules is about the way he feels as though his lover isn't being completely truthful with him and something feels off. His lover, but at the beginning he says, I call say I miss you. First verse I think threw me off because I call to say I miss you. Oh, he was just saying like, I miss you, like I haven't seen you in a few days, and he thinks she's being unfaithful. That, I think, is what the song is about. That was actually not that hard to figure out. I just don't have much of a brain, apparently. She's been looking at me all night. I'm terrified, I know why. Baby, she's got the wrong reason. verses are too good. The verses are too good. The chorus is like fine and I like it, but the verses are Oh, you see the fool in my mind. Can't run and hide. Stare on me. What are the fire? But he says fire. Rude. Did you hear that? Yeah.
Oh my fucking god, she fucking dead.
I'm feeling overwhelmed. Those verses are the best part of the song. Again, the rest of the song is good, but the verses are everything. I love the melody, I love his voice. I love the whole instrumental has this very like smooth, seductive feel to it. I mean, obviously, but oh, I love. Ooh, next is Nice to Meet You. I have a feeling I'm gonna recognize this song when it starts because it was a pretty big song, if I remember correctly. So, like, I feel like I must have heard it at some point, but we'll see. Oh. And I, oop.
She's not very good at this. She's left the phone behind.
Ooh, back in time. Ooh, let's go. Oh, he just put the shirt on. Wait, that was all one take. He did a quick change. That's really not that important, but okay. Be there. Every time I turn around, you disappear. Ooh! Pause. Hold off. This was definitely like the first single, like the radio hit. That's definitely what this was. I don't recognize the song though. Like, I don't think I've heard it, but it's so good. Also, I think this video has been one take. Ah, the lyrics, the melody, the friggin' production. Okay. Nice to meet you. Okay. Oh, now there's a cut. Okay. I want your number tattooed on my arm in ink, I swear. I love that drop. Also, I just didn't even comment on Mr. Mustache over there. Okay, now we're cutting. Oh my god, there she is! Aww. Wait, why did he look so cute when he does that? Hi. That was a fun video. I liked that the first section of it, I think, was a one take piece. Oh my god, look, it's my Flickr video. I really like this song. You can tell it's like the pop hit though. Like, let me check if it was the lead single. So Nice to Meet You is the first single from Niall's second studio album. So like that poster that said Heartbreak Weather, was that like an Easter egg? Like, you're supposed to like be like, oh my god, that's the title of the album. He put it in the first single video. Like, is that what happened? I really like that one. Oh no, not a piano. But the roses? No. We fight, we get high, holding on to love. We came down cause there was nothing holding us. Do you hate the weekend cause nobody's calling? Ooh. I'll put a little love on me. Put a little love on me. When the like, this just like, I feel very sad right now. Last night I lay awake, still come to things we say. And when I close my eyes, the first thing I hear you say is, put a little love on me. You're the only one I need. Put your your love for me. Oh my god! No, the way the lyrics changed throughout that whole song. They like progressed, because I think he said like, someone put a little love on me, and then you're the only one I need to put a little love on me, and then he says put your love on me. It just like hurt, you know what I mean? You know, like it just kind of like felt not good. On Twitter, Niall said that he played around with this song in different ways by recording different vocals or sounds, but ultimately ended up sticking with the demo he recorded on the first day. I love when artists do that. This could potentially be my favorite song I've ever written. Aww. I'd just gone through a breakup and it was all very real. It was very easy to sit down at the piano and speak and see what happens. That's so sad and beautiful and rude. I never thought that I would find out. We were just lovers in the dark. I was on my knees in the darkness. His voice? You'll be there to break my fall. You left me when I did. Now that I get any odds for a stranger. Why do I think of you? Ooh. You left me when I did for a stranger. Just trying to get up to you. Yeah. That was a nice song, but I think it's the first one that like I haven't really connected with in any way. I didn't really feel much of anything with this song. It's not bad, or it's a nice song, but like I didn't feel any like personal connection to it or anything. Next is Everywhere. This is one that I've just like, I don't know, I look at the title and I'm very intrigued. You walk into the room, I go quiet. I catch your eyes and don't blink an eyelid. Feels like the world locked us on an island. Mother thinks I'm the best for you. I like that lyric. Some of this instrumental reminds me of Coldplay a little bit. And I love Coldplay, so that's a good thing. Ooh, no, this is so Coldplay. Don't tell me it's not. Oh my god. Time I turn a corner, you're standing right there. Turn a corner, you're standing right there. Over my shoulder, you're everywhere. I swear it's hard to think, it's hard to breathe in the air. Ending is really good. I love the last, Also his voice on that one note, yes. I like that the song picks up from the verse, pre-chorus, chorus. It like picks up the whole time and then dips back down for the second verse. Beautiful, amazing. Next is a song called Cross Your Mind. Opening instrumental, enjoy it a lot. I really like that. I like this. It's your ocean, I wanna swim. Really? Oh, have you ever like let someone hurt you over and over again, leaving me in pieces, but I swear it's worth it every time. Is it though? Is it really worth it in the long run, Niall? Daydreaming about where you're. Wait, what does that sound like? Pull my heart out of my chest, drive a train through. Wait, no, that underneath sounds like something and it's gonna bot. No, it sounds like, what is the name of that song? I've been doing fine without you when I saw your face. That's the song it sounds like. I can't think of the name of it right now. Dude, he has so many Coldplay sounds in his music and I love that. That one's definitely one of my favorites. I adore it. From the lyrics, to his voice on it, to the melodies, to the beat. Every aspect of the song I absolutely loved. Love the way you hurt me and it doesn't even cross your mind. Give me all the pain. Give me everything. Don't hold back. The next song we are listening to is a song called New Angel. Yeah? Maybe it's time I need a new. Is that why the girl had the angel wings in the video before? Ooh. 'Cause you move me when you move it.
to know it, yeah. Give you what's left of me, left of me. Cause you feel so heavenly.
Oh, this bridge, this bridge. I like this one. I like the new Angel part. It's very like smooth, prolonged vocals. I'm here for it. Overall, probably not my favorite one. Didn't connect with it as much as some of the other songs on this album, but I do still really like this one. Next, you're listening to No Judgment, and this is the last music video that we're gonna be watching today. I need a new... See, New Angel is gonna be stuck in my head though. I can already tell.
There comes a time in the mating cycle of humans when the need to impress is replaced by a period they call no judgment. And let me tell you something. It gets a little bit strange.
What is going? Okay, what is going on? Where are we? Niall, what? You're such a goofy. Ooh, I love you so much. What the fuck is this trophy? Okay. Oh my god, where is this going?
Barefoot and a bottle of wine. You don't have to change when I'm around you.
Oh my god!
So go ahead and say what's on your mind.
Oh my god. The freaking banana.
You don't have to be
home. I love him.
You can get that from anyone else. You don't
have to. I love the song too.
We won't know that we'll move on again.
This is so cute. I love this.
Keep your secrets safe till the time we will find ourselves alone again. When you and me, no judgment.
Yes!
Told you.
I love the video. The video is so fun. It kind of had that same vibe, I think, as the Heartbreak Weather video in like color scheme and just like the overall feel of the video being over the top and like colorful and dramatic. I love the song though. When you and me, no judgment. Everyone else can judge us, but you and me, we don't judge each other. We don't judge us. We don't judge what we are. And I love the like the message of the song and the video. Oh my god, I loved it. Yay! I wonder if these last two songs are gonna be like upbeat or sad. Where are we going, you know?
Let all my defenses down, screaming to you, hear me out, I lay it on the line for
you.
My mind's made up. Take me back, take me back. San Francisco, show up on your doorstep, soaking wet. Say I'm done running from the one that I want so bad. Is there a way to make it up somehow?
Oh.
I wanna live and take me back, take me back.
That's beautiful.
San Francisco, I know I can't let go of you. Show up on your doorstep, soaking wet. Say I'm done running from the one that I want. So and take me back, take me back.
Oh. Wait, no, no. Guys? What is that sound? Honestly, that one might be my favorite one. I just really connected with that song. Lyrically, I just, and I don't know, it was really pretty. I like his voice on it. This one, oh my god, I really, 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 really like this one. Oh, Niall. He just broke me a little bit, but it's okay. San Francisco was a tough ride too. It was based on the start of a relationship and wanting to go back to where it started. I love it so much, aww. Guys, this has brought us to the final track on the album, at least on the standard edition of the album. It's a song called Still, and I don't know why, but like I kind of gravitated towards this title, so I'm excited to hear it. Let's hear the last track. Is it gonna be sad? It might be.
Overreacting lately, find it hard to say I'm sorry, but I'll make it up to you somehow. I just don't know why.
Oh no, no, no.
Find a steam, it's telling you the truth. But I'm still in love with you.
Niall!
This bitch, I swear to God.
I knew I was gonna gravitate towards this song. I knew it from just the word still. I was like, it's gonna hurt me.
Forget about what's coming on.
Is that a violin?
But I'm standing here with with you, just trying to be honest. If honest demon's telling you the truth, but I'm still in love with you.
So rude. The grand feel of this bridge is... You hear the depth in the production on this part? The layers! Oh, it's built so much, though.
But I'm still in love with you.
Not the last line on the album being, well, I'm still in love with you. Not that. Oh my god, stop. Okay. Perfection. Literal perfection. First of all, I can't believe he put like two of like the best songs right at the end of the album. This song is absolutely gorgeous. And I want to read what he says about it because I have like my own interpretation of it, but I think his interpretation is actually probably different from mine. Still is the quickest song I've ever written. I wrote it in about 7 minutes. I was in the studio and then the people I was working with went for dinner and I was in the studio on my own and I picked up this guitar, which was in a weird tuning, and I started singing and didn't stop. I kept going and wrote that I'm still in love with you after all of these songs I've written. The punchline is, I'm still in love with you. You're apologizing and you're doing a bit of self-deprecation, and then at the end it's, I'm still in love with you. No, wait, that's so beautiful that he literally finished it with, I'm still in love with you. That, I'm so obsessed with it. I'm so obsessed with the track placement and the song itself. Yes! See, to me, this song almost sounds like it's coming from a point of like you're in a relationship and it feels like it's coming to the end, but you don't want it to end because he's still in love with her. My interpretation is like after a relationship has already ended and like in the future coming back and looking back on it and saying, I'm still in love with you. I don't know which is like the right one, but the cool thing about music is there doesn't have to be a right one. You can kind of feel music however you need to and however you want to. We did it! We listened to Heartbreak Weather from my good friend Niall. We're not actually friends. That'd be cool if we were though. This is so beautiful and I love the concept of the album. This album is not just a bunch of beautiful songs, but I think it really does have such a good flow and a good vibe. The title being Heartbreak Weather and then all of these songs being like different emotions in relationships and a lot centering on heartbreak and like how weather is so, you know, changing all the time, just like the emotions throughout the album. I just think that's like a really cool concept for an album and I really love it. I think my two favorites are San Francisco and Still, and those are right at the end, but I also did just listen to those, so they might just be the freshest in my head. I'm such a Niall girl, it's disgusting. I think he's so perfect, it's... I'm like a 12-year-old One Direction stan right now. But in a few days, you guys, when I sit down to edit this video, this is my ranking of this album. Some of my favorites include Heartbreak Weather, Dear Patience, Nice to Meet Ya, Everywhere, Cross Your Mind, No Judgment, San Francisco, and Still, which I recognize is like basically half the album, but shh, don't worry about it. I think this is a fantastic album. Whether I could say like which album I prefer, I really don't know. I think both albums are really amazing in their own ways. I really don't think you can even compare his two projects because I think they're just so different, like so unique, and like it's kind of impossible to compare the two, at least in my opinion. But I mean, I love this. I love Niall. I love Niall so much. I just fucking love Niall. Okay, it's fine. But I guess that's it for Niall for now until he comes out with another album, which probably next year or the year after based on like when this one came out. I don't know. Maybe you guys have more information than I do. Thank you guys so much as always for being here, for supporting me, for supporting the one and only lovely Niall. Don't forget to like, subscribe down below if you want to, and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye guys.